You're welcome to the Forex Trading and Lifestyle Entrepreneurship Channel. If you take a minute to pause this video and read this disclaimer.
Hi, it's Victor here from ForeSureMarkets.com. In today's video, I will be sharing with you the concept of multi-time frame analysis. Okay, multi-time frame analysis. Basically, we're talking about how do you analyze the market. Most traders usually like to call it a top-down analysis. How do you analyze the market using higher time frame charts and lower time frame charts? Okay, looking at the big picture, maybe looking at data of over 3 days, 4 days, 1 month. Okay, and then drilling down to a smaller time frame to see, maybe on the 5 minute chart or the 15 minute chart, to see what is really, really going on in the market right now. Okay, so the concept of multi-time frame analysis is very, very important. First of all, of course, you must have heard me talking about D1. In my previous video, I talked about D1 daily time frame. So you have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You have 9 major time frames on the MetaTrader 4 charts. Okay, 9 major time frames on the MetaTrader 4 charts, and these are the different time frames that you use to analyze any market. Why is multi-time frame analysis very important? Okay, come with me as I use Euro dollar to do this analysis. Some of you may be wondering, why are my charts so my candles so small? Okay, I zoom out and make it small so that I can see a bigger picture, what is really going on in the market. Okay, when I need to get information on the individual candles, you can, in any particular area, you can zoom in into that particular area to see more information. Okay, but you can see now, I can see more information on this particular candle. Okay, and but the challenge is that you have reduced the bigger picture. You can't see much information about the bigger picture. 1 minute, I try to resize this. Okay, so as now you can see, you can zoom in, I can see more information on this candle, but then the bigger picture effect has disappeared. And really, I cannot make reasonable trading decisions, right? Just looking at what is going on at from the beginning of this chart to the end of this chart, because I'm only seeing a small amount of data. But when you zoom out, right? When you zoom out like this, you can see, I can really see what is going on in the market. This is an uptrend. Okay, this is an uptrend, a pullback here, and then we are trying to continue the trend. But when you zoom in, all of that historical uptrend has like here in this area, when you zoom in, you cannot really see that uptrend. As a matter of fact, this looks like a downtrend here or a sideways market. Okay, so that is why that is why the concept of multi-time frame analysis is important. Okay, if you cannot see the clear trend on the H4 time frame, then you can go to a higher time frame like D1. Okay, like D1, you can see, drag that to the side. Now D1 now shows me the full trend I was missing on H4. Okay, can you see this? D1 now shows me the trend that was missing on H4. So that means if you want to zoom your candles in like this, right, then you want to be using a higher time frame for your major analysis. So I'm changing this to weekly. As you can see, this shows me so much more information. So this is what we are seeing. But this is what we are seeing on this part here, is what we are seeing on the daily chart. But from here to the left, you cannot see it on the daily chart. So let me go to the daily chart so you see that. See? So you can see, we are seeing this part from here up. It is obviously an uptrend. Okay? But if you go to the weekly chart, and seeing a bigger picture, it shows you that This is what it shows you. Okay? It shows you that we were actually previously in a down trend. Okay? And then up. Now, if you look at the big picture, you can see that actually on the weekly chart and on the bigger time frame, we are actually in a sideways market. Can you see it? Down, up, down, up. No distinctive move to either side. Okay, so this is the importance of multi-time frame analysis. Okay, some people like to call it top-down analysis. Okay, you need to see the bigger picture first of all before you come down to a lower time frame to pick your trade. Okay, let me try to buttress this point by using the 1 minute chart. Okay, so the 1 minute chart is showing us what exactly is going on right now. Now, the 1 minute chart, if you look at, okay, let me show you how to show your see your open high low close of your candles on MetaTrader 4. Okay, to see your open high low close, simply come put your cursor on the candle, okay, and a window can pop up there. As you can see to the right, it shows you the time exactly of that candle, right? So of course it's going to be 1 minute interval. It shows you the open, it shows you the high, it shows you the low, and it shows you the close. If that window does not pop up, simply put your cursor on the candle and then come down here. Here you can see this window down here is for information. Okay, so I'll put that cursor back there, and you can see it gives you the time, it gives you the open price. At the bottom there is what I'm looking at now. Open, high, low, and close. Okay, so it's as simple as that to get information about your candle. Now I can proceed. Now if you look at the 1 minute chart, every single candle here is 1 minute. Okay, and it just simply tells you that the 1 minute chart is going to limit you to a particular period of time. So let me look at this. This is currently 8:33 on the 15th of July. So let's go back to the initial part of that chart. This is time here is what? 7:36 on same day, 15th of July. So between 7:36 to here, 8:36 thereabout is 1 hour. Okay? So this chart, 1 minute chart, is showing you price action for 1 hour only. Okay? Now you don't know what has happened in the last 4 hours, in the last 1 day. Okay? And so this looks like a downtrend on the 1 minute chart. Okay? But the reason why you cannot base your analysis on the 1 minute chart is because you don't know the big picture. Okay, so the 1 minute chart can deceive you, okay, to thinking that the market is going down because you have neglected the higher time frame. Okay, so let me take you. So established on the 1 minute chart, we're having a downtrend sideways market here. But it will shock you by the time you go to a higher time frame, say 1 hour. Okay, 1 hour time frame shows you that we are actually, you can see from the left here, we are actually in an uptrend. Okay, and let's see the data of the 1 hour. So currently today is 15th of July, and then the beginning of that chart is what? 13th of July. 13th of July to today, 15th of July. Each of these candles is 1 hour. So what I'm seeing here is 2 days of information. Okay, 2 days of information is better. 2 days of information on the 1 hour chart is so much more better than 1 hour of information that you see here on the 1 minute chart. Okay, so the importance of multi-time frame analysis is so that you don't get carried away by the movement on the lower time frame. If you base your decision on the lower time frame, 1 minute chart, you will be selling this market and thinking that the market is going to go down. Okay, but if you look at the 1 hour chart like I'm doing now, okay, you will see that the sell is actually a retracement, and that the major trend here is an uptrend, and so you should actually be looking for opportunities to buy. Okay, so the 1 minute chart is ideal for you to look for entry into a buying trade. Okay, so if you see the market going down on the 1 minute chart, then you can now start using all your technical analysis, your candlestick formation, support and resistance to look for a good place to buy. Okay, so this is the importance of multi-time frame analysis. And then when you take it higher to the 4 hour chart, so I'm going to 4 hour chart now, you can see that the 4 hour chart is actually buttressing the 1 hour chart and showing you that overall we are in an uptrend. Now remember, the 1 hour chart showed you 2 days of information. Let's see what the 4 hour chart is showing us. How many days of information is the 4 hour chart showing us? So today's date is 15th of July. I go back to the beginning of that chart, which is 2nd of July. So I have 13 solid days of information on this 4 hour chart. Okay, now a 4 hour chart will always be better than a 1 hour chart, because the 4 hour chart is showing you 13 solid days of information, while the 1 hour chart is showing you just 2 days worth of information. Okay, so the basic concept of multi-time frame analysis is that the higher the time frame, the more information you have and the more reliable your analysis will be. And so as a trader, most times you always start with maybe a daily time frame or a weekly time frame. Okay, establish your trend. Okay, so overall we are in a sideways market on the weekly chart. Okay, but on the daily chart we are in a clear uptrend. Okay, now weekly chart is a sideways market, and as you can see, we are getting close to resistance at the top there. Okay, so we have been in a sideways market from almost today's date. This is 12th of July 2020, and the beginning of this chart on the weekly chart is what, 2019, almost 1 year of information. Okay, so 1 year of information is far better than it's far better than 2 months or 13 days of information. Okay, now on the weekly chart you can see that we are in a sideways market, down, up, down, up. Okay, so on the weekly chart, what I should be thinking is that we are getting to a resistance point. And so if I'm to judge my decision based on the weekly chart, okay, I would not be buying this currency pair, because we are somewhere at the resistance. I can now be looking for opportunities to sell based on the weekly, okay, but then we have to wait for the daily to start, you know, to start. Like now it's doing a double top. Okay, so we have to wait for the daily to start aligning with the weekly chart, then we can start selling. An excellent way to be would be to use a double top here, put our neckline here, so we have a one top here. A possible double top is likely to come here based on the fact that we have looked at the weekly chart, and you can see that we are in a sideways market and we are at a resistance point. Okay, so it is not smart, it's not technically wise to be buying this based on the weekly chart. Okay, so we can say we should be looking for a sell, but the daily trend, the daily chart is in an uptrend, so you cannot just sell now, because you'll be going against the daily trend. What we need to do is wait for the daily trend to align with the weekly trend. Okay, and so we can use a simple concept of waiting for the neckline here, right? If this double top confirms, then we expect that the price is going to come down here and break this neckline. Okay, and once we break that neckline, we can sell. Put your stop loss, just like I taught you, above your resistance point, and then put your take profit, maybe 2 times of your stop loss or 4 times of your stop loss. Or based on the weekly chart, we're expecting the price to come back down to either this support here or this support here. Okay, and so your profit potential is actually from here down all the way to either here or here, for about 600 to 1000 pips. Okay, so this is an example of a multi-time frame analysis, starting from the weekly chart, okay, scrolling down to the daily chart. So weekly chart is basically sideways market, okay. Daily chart is an uptrend, okay. But we know that the higher the time frame, the more reliable the information. So you would want to align with the weekly interpretation of this chart, okay. And now wait for the daily to start reversing, give you some confirmation pattern, and then you can start selling, okay. So daily trend is showing us, currently showing us an uptrend, possible reversal pattern forming here for a double top. Okay, so let's look at the 4 hour. 4 hour, 4 hour, I see clearly an uptrend. Okay, 4 hour, I see clearly an uptrend. Okay, and then 1 hour, of course, I see clearly an uptrend. So the lower time frame are useful when you want to make your entry. Okay, for analysis of direction, you use the higher trend. Okay, then when you want to enter, so example, you can enter based on the daily chart at the break of this neckline. Okay, now if you want to get even more accurate entries, then you need to zoom down to the smaller time frame. So even after this price breaks this neckline here coming down, if you want to get more accurate entries, then you probably need to zoom down to the 4 hour, zoom down to the 4 hour or 1 hour, okay, for even more better entry. Because when this daily chart breaks, when the daily chart breaks that neckline here, it's not just going to do a straight down move, it is still going to do some funny move up and down inside the, excuse me, it's going to do some funny move inside the H4 and H1 time frame. So what you can see is, in the midst of this point, price may break down and go straight down, or it can still come back up here, right inside within this channel here, and then you can use your H4 and H1 to look for even better entry, and that will make you more profit trading this analysis. So this is basically just a simple example of how you do a top-down analysis from a higher time frame to lower time frame, and why it is extremely important. Okay, why it is extremely important. If you just go ahead and buy this because the daily trend is bullish, and you ignore the weekly analysis, you'll be shooting yourself in the foot, and the market will show you and prove to you that the higher time frames are more important and override the lower time frame. Okay, I think I think I've expanded this enough for you to get the basic concept. Okay, and so in the next video, I'm going to show you how we can put all this together if you're trading pure price action trading. All right, so if you've learned something new in the video, give us a thumbs up. Okay, also if this is the first time watching any of our videos, make sure you click the subscribe button, and also click the bell beside the subscribe button, click on notification so that you get notified whenever we upload a new video. Okay, I really enjoyed that analysis. If you enjoy the analysis, give us a thumbs up. Okay, drop me a question in the comment section, and let me know what you think about this kind of analysis. But before I go, you can see that if you look at the weekly time frame, when I zoomed out, I was zoomed in, all we can see is the sideways market. But when I zoom out, okay, you can see that overall we are in a downtrend. But guess what? What's this date? Okay, this candle is showing 12th of July, and then the beginning of this chart here is showing 15th of April 2018. So we are seeing about 2 years of information, which is much higher than the 1 year of information. So another way you can see this is, you can zoom back in. Now you're seeing a sideways market. If you change it to a higher time frame, which is the monthly time frame, it now shows you a bigger picture. Now you can see that actually we are in a downtrend, okay, but the weekly chart is showing us a sideways market. Okay, so this you have to be dynamic. So if you want to trade, so this actually means that when you're, this actually means that we are actually in a downtrend on the monthly time frame. Okay, so if you sell this based on the weekly chart, okay, entering on the daily chart, it is very likely that we are coming back down to this bottom based on the overall prevailing trend. Okay, let's see what amount of information this is showing us. This is for the monthly. This is July 2020, and then we started this chart at the beginning of December 2015. So let's just say 2016. So the monthly chart is showing me 4 years of information. Okay, 4 years of information. And then when you zoom out on the monthly, you can see that overall we are in a downtrend. Okay, we are in a downtrend overall on the monthly when you zoom out. And then looking at the beginning of this chart, I'm seeing 2011. So from the beginning of this chart here to the end, I am seeing 10 years of information. And using 10 years of information, I can confidently tell you that the euro dollar is in a downtrend. Okay, trying to form a double bottom here, and this is a neckline. Okay, so it's all about top down analysis, doing from the higher time frame to the lower time frame, and you base your trading decision off that. Okay, if you are trading the daily time frame, weekly time frame, you know that your trade is going to take months to reach its take profit. But if you are trading on the week, on the 4 hour, 1 hour, maybe it can take a few days. Okay, so if you want to make quick trades, then it means you want to be trading on the 1 minute, 5 minutes, 15 minute chart for trades that can last maybe 1 hour, 4 hours, and all of that. Okay, so it's all dynamic, all depends on what kind of trader are you. Are you a scalper? Are you a day trader? Or are you a swing trader or a position trader? Probably I think I'm going to do a video on that as well. All right, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.